The fighting around Saigon in the last 2 days we were there was desperate. The fight for Newport Bridge, only 2 miles out of Saigon, was the bloodiest we've seen. Early Monday morning, a Viet Cong sapper unit, probably no more than 20 or 30 men and women, attacked and set fire to an American USAID installation, closing the bridge and Highway 1. Thousands of troops and refugees were trapped on the other side of them, unable to reach the safety of the capital. Again and again, this company of South Vietnamese troops worked their way down the far side of the bridge, and again they were mortared, taking many casualties, leaving many dead.
The troops are now moving down on the other side of Newport Bridge. He's trying to, there's AK fire coming in from the factory. But now they've crossed the hump of the bridge, it means they're advancing anyway. We still don't know how many there are down there. We thought about 12 earlier today. An armored car's going up on the left. There's no way of shifting these people. There must be, what, 500 or 600 troops on this bridge, fighting probably a dozen or so, maybe 20 at the most, communists, and yet there they are, they've been there all today. The mortar hit right in the middle of them down there on the right, 100 yards away. It's killed a lot of people. But now they've gone back to some of their positions. They've left one wounded in the road.
There was a desperation in these troops and their commanders we'd not seen before. Despite the mortars hitting the bridge to the left, only 50 yards away, these men kept their places, pulling their dead and wounded out and returning. The wind turned and smoke from the burning installation began blowing back into their faces, confusing their movements and giving the Viet Cong ahead cover enough to move their positions. Then through the smoke, we could just see a Viet Cong running left to right, just for a second or so, and then falling as he was hit by machine gun fire. Quickly, the very forward unit of South Vietnamese ran throwing hand grenades 30 feet ahead of them. The smoke turned on us again, and out of it, in the briefest lull in the crossfire, soldiers came running out carrying children. Children who had been trapped by the side of the road, right in the middle of all that we'd seen. They'd been hit by flying shrapnel from the mortars. One little girl was very close to dying. And also out on a stretcher came a young woman, also badly wounded. She was dressed in a black uniform, and there was a rifle on the stretcher with her. She was a Viet Cong. The firefight lasted another 2 hours, but because of our open position on the bridge, there was no way we ourselves could get out. But a final charge and a last volley of hand grenades, and the fight to reopen Newport Bridge on Highway 1 was over.
So the battle for Newport Bridge ends this evening.
back in South Vietnamese hands. And a half an hour ago, these men were told that they had a new president. President Minh installed in the presidential palace, the man who they hope, we hope, will bring peace to this country. Michael Nicholson, News at 10, on the new port.